Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain about line defect in crystals. In my previous video, I have already explained about point defect in crystal. You can find the link in the description below. So what actually is line defect and how many types of line defects are there? In this video, I'm going to explain everything about that. So let's start. Just like point defect, line defects are also very common in crystals. Line defect, the concept is clear from the topic itself. Line means the defect will be along the whole line. So, the defect in crystals, which extends through a line. is called line defect. So this is the definition of line defect. In this, the defect is not only situated at a particular point like point defect, but the defect extends through the whole line, that is like this line. Okay, so this defect is called line defect. There are two types of line defects. They are, the first one is edge dislocation, and the second one is screw dislocation. There is one more type of defect in which we find both of the defects simultaneously. So in third case, there will be edge defect and screw defect simultaneously. Now, let's see one by one. First of all, we will read about edge defect, then we will study about screw defect. First of all, let's understand edge dislocation. In edge dislocation, there will be defect in edges of the crystal. Suppose the crystal is in the rectangular form, just like this. Now, let's consider a scenario in which this lower breadth is constant. Now, this upper breadth keeps on expanding and expanding. Then what happens? There is the creation of defect. That's what happens in case of edge dislocation. Are you getting confused? Let's understand this by a diagram which will help us understand this very properly. Now look at here. The ideal crystal or the perfect crystal is in this type of shape. Like that means the atoms are arranged in a proper way. Suppose this is the perfect crystal. This is the crystal structure and the atoms are in there. Crystal lattice. That is lattice site. They are in their lattice site. Lattice site is like home of atoms in a crystal. This is the ideal crystal. Okay. Now, let's consider another plane, half plane. Okay, how many atoms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. In this line, that is in y-axis, how many atoms are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 atoms are there. And this is the half part of this total line, right? Total crystal. Then let's consider a half plane in which there are 2 atoms. That means there will be the plane will be like this. We insert a plane over here. Now, by inserting the plane, what happens? These atoms will get repelled and these atoms will change its position. This atom will come here. This atom will come here. Similarly, this atom again comes here and this atom comes where? Here. Now what happens? This is the new structure that we get. This is actually the new crystal that we get. Now these two are the edges of the crystal. Now look at here. This lower edge or the lower breadth is constant. The length of lower breadth is constant, but the length of upper breadth is expanding, right? It is increasing. So this is not a perfect crystal anymore. Now this defect is along the edges of the crystal. These are the edges of the crystal. So these defects are called edge dislocation. Now if you need to write it, how do we write it? Look at here. In edge dislocation, an extra plane is inserted in the crystal. Extra half plane is inserted in the crystal that creates the defect along the line and is called what? Edge dislocation. So you just saw over here, initially the crystal was in perfect shape, but when we insert the half plane, then the shape of the crystal is distorted. So this is the creation of defect that is called edge dislocation defect. Okay, we generally find this type of form in which we get half plane in that. So this is what we call edge dislocation. Now if this moves, this is called slip. You can see over there, this is reverse T, right? This is reverse T. So if we get reverse T effect, this is called positive edge dislocation. And if it is like this, non-reverse T, if the plane was inserted from lower side, then this would be called negative edge dislocation. So this is what we called edge. This is what edge dislocation actually is. Now let's see the screw dislocation. Now let's understand about screw dislocation. This defect is called screw dislocation because it actually looks like screw. Now let us consider this duster is the crystal. Then let me apply the force. In this defect, we apply the force. Suppose I'm using my right hand to apply the force in this direction. I'm using my left hand to apply the force in another direction, that is completely opposite direction. Then what happens? This is rotating right. Now this is hard, so it does not feel any effect. But in case of crystal, what happens when we apply the force in opposite direction? The atoms of this portion, the middle portion, actually gets displaced and change its position. So that creates the defect. Now let's understand that by a figure. This is the perfect crystal that we actually found, that we need to get. This is the what? Perfect crystal. Okay, this is the perfect crystal. The crystal should be in this structure, but no, due to the thermal effect, the crystal is not in this defect, and because of the stress, the defect is produced in the crystal. Now in screw defect, what happens? Now look at here, the crystal gets a defect like this. Okay, you can see over here, I've just made the diagram of it. What actually happens when we apply the stress in opposite directions, from here downward, from here upward, then we get this type of form, this type of structure, or this type of diagram in case of crystals. Here, this part, from this part, the atoms have been moved. The atoms should be here in this line, but the atoms move along this line. Similarly, this happens over here as well. The atoms move from this point to this point, that thereby creating the defect. This is the figure for स्क्रू डिसलोकेशन, स्क्रू डिसलोकेशन. So you see from here, the atoms are moved and this looks like screw, right? So this is called screw dislocation. Now let's write little bit about this. When stress is applied on two opposite directions of the crystals, then there is the creation of screw dislocation. This is also very prominent defect found in crystal, okay, because of the stress this defect is produced. Now there is one more defect, I have already talked about that, that is called the mixed dislocation defect, in which we find screw dislocation and edge dislocation defect simultaneously. Now that's all in this video. I hope you like the video, and if you like the video, please share this video as much as you can. Thank you for watching the video.